right now. How's it looking, Bonnie?
Well, Allie, we still have at least one, if not 2 days more for stormy conditions in California, particularly in Southern California. That part of the country just getting hammered with nonstop rain. The steady flow from the Pacific continues. San Diego, you're getting drenched at this hour. Los Angeles, too. And then notice in the mountains, you can see those pockets of snow. We still have advisories for rain and snow for the entire region. These flash flood advisories persist as far east as into Las Vegas. 1 to 3 inches expected tonight and especially for Wednesday. So it's not raining right now, but I am anticipating that rain to pick up in Las Vegas tomorrow. Look at all the snow anticipated, too, for parts of the Rockies, further off to the west into Utah. A lot of it, we're measuring it by the feet here, 6 feet of snow. So this is a major snow event for many states across the west. And speaking of snow, we still have more of it, but it looks like Minneapolis is getting spared by another real hammering of snow. This is a fast-moving system that is going to bring substantial snow to northern Wisconsin and parts of Michigan as it advances to the east. And let's head even further east to the northeast. So far, so good in terms of seeing a lot of snow this season, although maybe you want it over there. But one thing's for sure, the winds are picking up. Look at the winds in Boston. Right now, it's bringing down the wind chill factor about to about 20 degrees. It'll get even colder than that tonight. It's also windy in New York City. That brisk northwest wind really can make a difference. And is it impacting travel? Let's take a quick look at airport delays. You'll see in Chicago, we have delays as well as in Newark. That's related to the wind. And also, we're looking at San Francisco, some delays there. 40 minutes. Allie?
Those are pretty substantial delays in Chicago, over 2 hours. I mean, such a big hub for a busy travel week. All right, Bonnie, thanks very much for sticking on top of that for us. We'll check in with you again right now.
Just a flash mob. The weather is major news today, especially out west. Meteorologist Bonnie Schneider is here, and we're talking record rain, snowfall. I mean, this has been rough. It's been a rough go for the last few days for them.
That's right, Brooke. 4 days of steady rain in California. It is the rainy season, but this has been tremendous.
Yeah.
5 inches of rain in the Los Angeles area from this event, and it's still raining. Take a look at the radar. I'd like to show you that it's subsiding, but it isn't. It's actually getting heavier to the south, like in San Diego. That's where we have heavy rain right now. And with all this rain coming through, naturally flooding has been a huge problem. And some now, this rain isn't just affecting Southern California. It's now spread further to the east, so we're seeing it across Nevada. And with that said, Las Vegas, 1 to 3 inches of rain in the forecast. We're watching out for advisories there. Where it's cold enough, we have a lot of snow. We're measuring it by the foot. We have some pictures of the snow that's been accumulating. Expect quite a bit. Look at this, 4 inches, particularly to the south from Orange County southward into San Diego as we watch this event unfold. Now, there is some good news depending on how you look at it. The storm system will eventually start to dry out Thursday. We actually have sunshine in the forecast for California Thursday. But look at this low. This piece of energy treks across the southern tier of the country, then pulls offshore by the end of the weekend. Now, this may mean a white Christmas for many folks across parts of the Great Lakes. The problem is Sunday's a busy travel day. So with the storm sitting offshore, we'll likely get some strong wind and some substantial snow, possibly for coastal areas of New England. And then wind, of course, bringing down colder temperatures for the Great Lakes and maybe once again here in the south. So we'll be monitoring that. All right, one last mention for temperatures. You got to see these high temperatures yesterday in Texas. Let's zoom in right here. You'll see Wichita Falls climbed up to 84 degrees. Dallas, Texas, not listed here, was 79 yesterday. Brooke, the average temperature is 56 down to 47 Christmas Day. Big changes.
Wow, how about that? I will take that warm any day of the week. Bonnie Schneider, thank you so much.
Sure.
Getting some information in my ear. We've been talking to you about this procedural. There is still no relief in sight for those of you in California just inundated by all the pictures we are getting in. Bonnie, let's just take a look at some of these pictures together.
Further to the east, but remember, even when it all stops, we still have a lot of runoff, which is what we saw this morning in Laguna Beach when the downtown streets were just closed and officials said, don't even try to come to work today. The roads are impassable. So what's happening right now is we have steady rain, Orange County, and then to the north in L.A., to the south in San Diego. And as we open up the scope, you'll see the rain stretches all the way into Las Vegas. That's another place that's really getting hit hard with a lot of rain at this hour. We're anticipating that wanting to get out as fast as possible. Also, there's devices that you can use, Brooke, that are kind of puncture the windows that you, if you had to escape, you can. This is in a worst-case scenario, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, that's what people are finding themselves. But now we're also looking at a lot of snow. I have to show you the snow measured by the foot, 17 feet. That's one of the highest snowfall totals I've ever seen. That's in parts of California as well. In Colorado, still seeing a lot of heavy snow. And then to the northeast, as we head across the country, Brooke, we're also tracking some travel troubles. And we're seeing that in Boston, where we have light snow falling and some cold temperatures. And you can see there's a lot of delays as a result of that.
It is that time of year, isn't it?
It is.
I'm heading to sunny SoCal tomorrow. not so sunny in San Diego it's looking. Bonnie, thank you very much. And now, look at this story.